ever find, the more wretched hive of scum and villainy. We must be cautious.
Hey guys, welcome back to the Cantina. This is Stephanie, your friendly neighborhood bar manager, Wookiee Wrangler, Chaos Coordinator, Scoundrel, Wrangler, Scoundrel Keeper, Star Wars fan. We talk Star Wars here, and all the rest of that stuff. More hints came today about things not being kosher, I think, or not going very well for the sequel trilogy. Let me explain. Here is something I want you to see. And go over to Matt Martin at Missing Words on Twitter and see for yourself. But I've got a screenshot. So this is the tweet. Martin's done it before. This will come in handy. It's a tweet of Kyle fading into the bushes a la The Simpsons. Matt Martin's done this before with saying cryptic things like, it's all fake anyway when referring to canon. So let's just see what happens. Okay, add that to the piece of the cartoon animated series Rebels, in which Ezra is closing the portal. The son says, I'll let you watch it. Yeah, Matt Martin saying what he said. You saw the tweet. You've got the son saying this, and more news coming out every day of just what an abomination the sequel trilogy was. Doomcock posted a great video, basically based on something that Chewbacca wrote about how bad the filming for The Rise of Skywalker is. I'm going to jump in and say, if you see the tweet, Matt Martin at Missing Words on Twitter posted, and he has hinted at things changing before, like somebody talked about canon, and he said, none of it's real anyway. Okay, so I'm going to say something. And if you are a fan of Adam Driver, boo-hoo. Okay, I'm not. I don't like the guy. I don't care if he's serving the Marine Corps or not. I don't like him. I think he's a pretentious Juilliard-trained dickhead who's long forgotten the too short time he spent in the Marine Corps. Okay? This latest tweet Matt put out there is a pretty strong indication that not only are they probably going to decanonize or push the sequel trilogy that they created, the mess they created, into a place we don't have to suffer about it anymore. But the characters that we all despise and hate are going away too, or they're going to be relegated to legends. Now, yesterday I took offense at some in the Phantom Menace feeling bad for those who were going to probably lose their favorites. Well, I lost Jaina Solo and Jason and Anakin, and I got to see my two favorites, Han and Leia, kicked in the Han get castrated by Kathleen Kennedy, and Leia get turned into, I don't know what the fuck that was. Do you think I care? No. But it looks to me like it's happening. And again, the reason is simply Disney can't afford any more bullshit. I mean, Doomcock even raised the question, did The Rise of Skywalker with its massive reshoots going all the way up to mid-November, by the way, right before the movie came out. Did it even make any money? It barely limped over the billion-dollar mark. Barely. Now, we could have those saying, $1 billion is a lot of money. Yeah, it is. No one's disputing that. But when you're talking about franchises the size and scope of Star Wars, that's not even $5 in a jar. Okay? It's not. And this has been an incoherent mess from the beginning. The Force Awakens, which sucked. And TLJ, which sucked harder. And then the sad denouement, the weeping funeral that was Tross. It all sucks. Okay. They have to do something. They built Galaxy's Edge for a purpose. And that's been a failure. Well, part of it's because Kathleen Kennedy just decided she had to be part of it. She had to stick her nose in a place that doesn't belong. All right? We want to sell ours. Sell ours. You know, it's whatever. But this Matt Martin tweet really kind of struck me as being very interesting. Hold on to this. And I don't agree that they're not going to say anything. You got Martin saying this. I have a feeling this is all going to happen a lot sooner than we think. The moment Kennedy's gone, and it's not going to be 2021 in August, I think she's going to be gone sooner. And this, and I think they all know it now. You know, I have a feeling, and this is just me theorizing right now, but when Pablo Hidalgo secured his Twitter account so we can see what he was saying, I had a feeling that they knew this was going on, this was going to happen months ago, maybe even before The Rise of Skywalker. I just do. And the reason simply is this. I really think the accountants, the guys that do that stuff, the bean counters, and Iger and the rest of them sat down and looked at each other and said, you know, and Pablo had a temper tantrum and closed off his account. You know, well, we don't know because they're so closed mouth. But we do have Matt Martin, and Matt Martin is very, he's not shy about putting hints out there and watching, you know, creepy fade into the bushes is just, wow. All right, now here's the deal. He could be trolling us, or he could be hinting at things coming that are happening. All right. Funny, the trolls like Star Wars Explained. I haven't heard one word from Steele Saunders about any of this. Jason Ward has disappeared completely. I mean, he's tweeted 20 times, and 11 of those times, 22 times, half of them were retweets since, I think, mid-April, when all this personal stuff went down with him. I think they know, all right? I think that they know. I think they don't know how to deal with it. I assume that some of them might want to fight back, but there you go. Of course, it also could be the fact that Jason Ward's been called out for being a pervert, too. But again, there is something definitely pointed about these rumors that Doomcock and Midnight's Edge and others, people I talk to, and then putting out there. They all kind of coincide together. They all fit together. One person fills in a part of the story that the other person didn't have. You understand? It's like putting together a puzzle. So what does this mean? I think, and I'm sticking to this, and this is me thinking, sooner rather than later, and sooner I mean by the end of the summer, Kathleen Kennedy, maybe even in the fall, when the last quarter Disney has to produce its last quarter earnings, which ought to be just ducky. Because I'm still waiting for their last quarter report. No dividends this time, guys. That she's probably going to walk away. I just have that feeling. And it's right in here. And the reason why is this. Why would you stay in a place where you're not allowed to base, your job has been taken over by somebody else? Everything that you've worked for is being set aside, if not completely obliterated and discontinued. That you're not even asked your input on new projects coming. See where I'm going? So, wolves in a, the part of World Between Worlds where Ezra puts his hand on the portal over the sun's closed fist. He's going like that. Ezra puts his hand like that over it. Uses the force to close the portal. And the you know, you tell me what you hear. The sun says something, and then he says, the future can be changed. I was like, holy shit, when I heard that, when I started putting it all together. The keys are there for them to do exactly what they're going to do. Who eventually gets into the veil and gets Palpatine before he can jump in to wherever he's, before he can get to Exegol? Luke, hopefully. Ahsoka, Ezra. You know, we don't need the newbies doing that. We need Luke. We need Skywalkers. This is their story, actually. Okay. So, it's almost a cut and dry deal. All right. So, anyway, I kind of want to talk a little bit about that. Matt Martin's cryptic tweet with Kylo Ren going into the bushes. And what I think is going to be Kennedy's exit strategy. Why would she want to stay around? All right, it's kind of weird. This is Steph signing out. See you later.